every once in a while, a show comes along that seems to exist for the sole sake of selling a product. Shows like Transformers or Power Rangers, where, once you get past whatever characters or storylines there may be, are little more than glorified commercials. From Japan. In the new millennium, we got a show that was, well, different. See, unlike its predecessors, whose premises could allow for a wide variety of merchandise, this show liked to focus on one product in particular. Trading cards. I'm, of course, talking about Yu-Gi-Oh! A show where the fate of the world rested on the shoulders of a young boy, the spirit of an Egyptian pharaoh, and a children's trading card game. In spite of that ridiculous premise, however, Yu-Gi-Oh! Took the minds of the American youth by storm, achieving a status close to that of Pokémon. So, of course, the creators eventually decided to cash in on the cash-in in the form of a feature-length movie that was sure to keep kids spending their hard-earned allowance on trading cards. So, strap yourselves in. It's time to duel!
We open to our protagonist, Yugi Moto, as he assembles the pieces of an ancient Egyptian artifact, the Millennium Puzzle, not realizing that by doing so, he threatens to unleash unspeakable evil on the world.
Long ago, when the pyramids were still young, Egyptian kings played a game of great and terrible power. Until a brave and powerful pharaoh locked the dark magic away, imprisoning it for all eternity within the mystical Millennium items. It was never to happen, and for 5,000 years, it never did.
Then this kid came along and effed it all up.
It was never to happen.
Yeah, you said that already. Anyway, we then cut to a group of archaeologists in Egypt as they uncover the lost tomb of Anubis.
Amazing! What possessed them to put the sarcophagus in chains?
Well, whatever the reason, I'm sure this doesn't foreshadow our imminent demise or anything.
This is it!
Behold the destruction wrought by a 14-year-old boy with ridiculous hair!
However, before our hero is forced to suffer the consequences of his own naivete, the spirit of the pharaoh, who conveniently looks just like him, emerges from the Millennium Puzzle.
Shadow creatures, begone! I command you! Return to the dark realm from whence you came!
It was never to happen.
We know!
The Shadow Games begin again.
Oh yeah, and for those of you watching who haven't seen Yu-Gi-Oh!, the whole idea behind the Duel Monsters card game is that it's actually a recreation of ancient Shadow Games once played by Egyptian pharaohs, which is why everyone in the show takes it so seriously. We then flash forward 3 years to where the whole world is gathered around to watch the Exposition Channel, as it recounts the various card game playing adventures Yu-Gi has had since he started sharing his body with an ancient Egyptian spirit and rose to the status of Duel Monsters champion.
But what makes this young man such a talented duelist? Is it his masterful strategies? Or does the secret lie in the powerful god cards he's assembled in his deck?
Yeah, does it have anything to do with those one-of-a-kind, unbeatable monsters he has in his deck? That's like asking if the British were able to stave off Napoleon because of, oh, I don't know, the ocean.
Give me a break. I bet I could duel circles around this little high school pipsqueak.
If he'd play me for those god cards, I'd take that chump down in a flash.
And so we see duelists from all over the world preparing to challenge Yugi for his title. Surely this means we'll see an onslaught of new and compelling characters posing a challenge the likes of which our hero has never faced.
You wanted a rematch, Seto Kaiba? You've got one.
And this time, things are gonna end differently, you pompous windbag.
Oh, he's dueling Kaiba. Which happened in the first episode.
I play a magic card that doubles my dragon's attack points. Megamorph! Now my Blue Eyes is more powerful than any monster on the field.
There's more to power than just attack points.
Ha! And just what is that supposed to mean?
By sacrificing two of them, I can bestow upon the third infinite strength.
How is that any different?
Arbalisk the Tormentor! Show him what true power is all about!
And how it has nothing to do with attack points!
System overload.
The simulation is malfunctioning!
And it wasn't even a real duel. That's disappointing.
And so we meet Yugi's longtime rival Kaiba, a child billionaire who, ever since losing his title of champion in the first episode, has been desperately trying to win it back.
There's gotta be some way to defeat Yugi's god cards, and I think I know where to start looking.
Then why didn't you just start there in the first place?
So Kaiba blasts off in his private jet. Wow, can you tell this guy likes dragons? To seek out the ever-fabulous creator of Duel Monsters, Maximilian Pegasus. Oh, and apparently Kaiba has a theme song now.
Don't say if I were you, or tell me what you'd do. How things would be if you were in my shoes, cause you're not me.
Sorry, Mr. Kaiba, I just don't understand why we need to invest millions of dollars in a jet shaped like a blue-eyes white dragon.
Did you even listen to my theme song?
Yes, but I fail to see what that has to do with—
Cause you're not me.
You created the god cards and would have never let them out of your sweaty little hands. Unless you'd also created a way to beat them. Just in case.
Oh, very well, I confess. I may have one card that would help, but you can't have it.
What?
Yugi has trounced your sorry behind again and again. Quite frankly, it's embarrassing.
Well, since I'm such a disappointment, you should have no trouble defeating me in a duel.
And why would I duel you?
Because if you'll put up the card I need to beat Yugi, I'll wager these.
And that's not all. I'll also throw in the jet.
Wow, you'd risk your precious blue eyes white dragons just for a chance to trounce little Yugi? Well, I guess I could dust off my deck.
Whoa, man, I don't need to know about the things you do with your deck. So Pegasus accepts Kaiba's challenge, leading to yet another face-off that we've already seen.
I'll throw two cards face down. For later.
Ooh, I'm so scared, Kaiba. Two cards face down. Oh, mercy me. What will I do?
Okay, can we cut the smack talk? I mean, if I had to choose between listening to bad dialogue and watching a children's card game... Okay, so Pegasus sacrifices 1,000 life points, allowing him to play his Toon World card, which allows him to summon Toon monsters that can attack Kaiba's life points directly. So Kaiba then plays a card called Soul Release, which allows him to remove two of his monsters from the game, but he then plays a card called Return from a Different Dimension to bring those monsters back, and combine them with Z Metal Tank to form the XYZ Dragon Head, which he then uses to destroy Pegasus' Toon World card along with all of his monsters. If you're hoping I'm gonna stop to explain all this, I'm not. So, Kaiba defeats Pegasus in a whopping 2 turns and claims his prize.
Looks like you had 2 cards up your sleeve.
What do you mean? 2 cards? Kaiba, there was only one!
Yeah, whatever. I don't have time for your plot points. Bye. Alright, that's enough of Kaiba for now. Let's check in on Yugi.
It's him! Told you he's a lot smaller than on TV!
Me first! Let me at him!
So we see a crowd of people all clamoring for a chance to duel Yugi. Being the superior duelist he is, I'm sure he'll face this challenge head on and...
Say it! Try and sneak Yugi out around back while we hold them off!
You sure?
Yeah, me and Tristan will handle things here!
Thanks, Joey!
Oh yeah, I forgot. He's supposed to be all meek and unassuming. So Yugi runs off with token girl character slash love interest, otherwise known as Taya, while his friends Joey and Tristan handle the mob.
Out of the way, we want to take on Yugi, not you.
Yeah, right!
We want the king of games, not the king of lame!
The Duel Monsters champ, not chump!
The master of the gods, not the master of the clods!
Great job, everyone! Those 6 months spent in rehearsals were totally worth it!
You gotta prove yourselves first by dueling a top contender. Me, Joey Wheeler! So if you wanna get to the king of games, you'll have to go through me! The godfather of games, capisce?
Proceed.
So Joey's able to fend off the challengers.
Is the coast clear yet, Joey?
Hey, it's Yugi! He's back!
Wow, and he's a dumbass too? I'm so rooting for this guy! In fact, is he even supposed to be the protagonist? I mean, so far the only character we've seen with any motivation is Kaiba. Hell, Joey's more of a hero than Yugi. At least he's actually doing something.
I could have been a contender.
We get it. You're from Brooklyn. So Taya takes Yugi to hide in a place where the card game-obsessed public would never think to look. A museum. There, they run into Yugi's grandpa, who, apparently likes to dress like Fire Mario, who has come to see a new exhibit with artifacts from the prologue.
This
says it's called the Pyramid of Light.
It belonged to an evil sorcerer who tried to bring about the end of the world. Legends say a brave pharaoh destroyed him using the mystical dagger of fate. The same pharaoh who many believe possessed your Millennium Puzzle.
Wait, you're telling me that someone in the show actually accomplished their goal without the use of trading cards?
It's some sort of prophecy. The eye that sees what's yet to come, its vision shall be fulfilled. Unless blinded by events predetermined, thus light and shadows both be killed.
Then this happens.
From the light comes the dark!
Yugi?
They then wake up from the weird prophetic spirit vision to find that the mummy has been stolen.
The mummy's body's been stolen!
That's not all. He nabbed that pyramid thing too.
Hey look, witnesses! You think we should question them?
Nah, you see how fast that kid hightailed it out of here? He's probably got something more important to do. Like play a children's card game. As Yugi's leaving the museum, he's cut off by Kaiba's brother, Mokuba.
My brother sent me to find you, and he said that it's real important that you bring your dual disc right away.
Wait, so he's okay then?
I wouldn't say he's okay. All I know is that Seto hasn't been acting like himself lately.
Why? Because he spent this entire movie obsessing over trading cards? This is the guy who flies around in a jet shaped like a dragon. The guy who threatened to kill himself if he lost a duel. If you ask me, he's acting pretty normal. So Yugi arrives at Kaiba's special card game stadium and yields control over to his Egyptian alter ego, as he's usually the one who takes care of all the important things. Like, you know, the plot. He then heads off to face Kaiba, who I'm still convinced is the real hero of this movie.
Something tells me that this duel is not a good idea.
Then why did you get in the car?
You're about to lose big time. Mokuba, seal all of the exits!
If you say so.
Okay, this is officially a kidnapping. Seriously, he's holding Yugi against his will with a card game as ransom.
I guess Yugi's going through with this.
Kaiba ain't leaving him much choice.
Oh, he has a choice. All right, Il-Nej, this is it. I've sealed the exits. You have no choice but to face me in a... What are you doing? Hmm? Oh, I'm calling the police. Yeah, I'd like to report a kidnapping. Yeah, this guy, he's sealed all the exits. Yeah, a children's card game. Yeah, it does sound kind of stupid, doesn't it?
My entire strategy was to draw out your three Egyptian god cards, so I can be the first duelist to crush all of them at once! Reveal trap card! Pyramid of Light!
So the Pyramid of Light is more than just an ancient artifact!
It's also a trading card!
So Kaiba activates the Pyramid of Light, which removes Yugi's god cards from the game, with some unforeseen side effects.
It hurts, doesn't it? When you put your faith in the gods and they let you down.
Wow, it's great to know that even God isn't off limits when it comes to writing Kaiba dialogue. So the duel continues, but things start to get real as Yugi and Kaiba seem to lose energy with every attack.
Kaiba, we can't continue this duel. There's another power at work here, and it's destroying us both.
That's getting a bit old.
Kaiba, once again, your ridiculously overinflated ego blinds you to the truth.
Oh, says the guy who won't throw a match to save the world? Seriously, if Kaiba isn't listening to reason, why don't you just surrender? You didn't have a problem surrendering to an 8-year-old girl. Why should your title matter to you now? Or, if it really means that much to you, just stall. Wait till it's your turn and filibuster. You guys spend more time talking than you do actually playing the game anyway. Kaiba probably wouldn't notice.
I sacrifice both magicians to summon the Sorcerer of Dark Magic! Now, will you stop this madness?
After one lucky move? I don't think so.
Very well, Kaiba, you leave me no choice. I move to attack Petten the Dark Cloud!
Wait, show me that again!
I move to attack Petten the Dark Cloud!
They're not even playing by the rules anymore! Okay, so here's the basic breakdown of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Card game. Draw a card, play a monster, attack with that monster, end of turn. So why did Yugi just attack, draw another card when he shouldn't have been able to, then attack again? And look, before he even does that, Kaiba draws a card implying that he's about to start his turn. Now, I haven't seen this movie in the original Japanese, but I looked this scene up. For the entire match, Kaiba has had a virus card that takes 10 cards out of Yugi's deck every turn. Here, we see him start a turn that he then decides to end immediately because he assumes that the virus card will just wipe Yugi's deck out on the next turn and win him the duel. That's it. 3 seconds of interior monologue. But I guess 4Kids thought that would have made the movie drag, so they decided to cut it at the cost of this card game making any sense. Yeah, I know I'm ripping on a movie about trading cards. I don't care!
I activate the magic of Monster Reborn! Then I sacrifice my reborn ultimate dragon to summon a new monster, the Blue-Eyes Shining Dragon!
You heard him, kids, the Blue-Eyes Shining Dragon, one of 4 cards available at any major theater screening of Yu-Gi-Oh! The Movie. Hurry to the theaters now for your chance to own this monster, the summoning of which is so incredibly unlikely that no one who actually knows how to play this game would keep one in their deck. If your parents say no, ask again, and don't stop asking until they finally concede to indulging your fleeting obsession with trading cards. Do it now! You don't want to be the only kid in your neighborhood stuck using Wattapon, do you? Meanwhile, Yugi, Joey, and Tristan find themselves trapped inside the Millennium Puzzle. So they decide to handle the less important, non-card game related task of explaining what the hell is going on.
I think this all has to do with an ancient Egyptian sorcerer. Centuries ago, he tried to destroy the world, and I'm starting to believe he's trying to make a comeback.
Yugi and Kaiba are inside something from 5,000 years ago. And if the myth is true, then Anubis is using it to finish what he started in the past.
This is crazy! We gotta get them out of there!
Aw, look at Mokuba trying to have an impact on the story.
Up here!
Pegasus Ex Machina!
So Pegasus explains that the Pyramid of Light card was actually planted by the spirit of Anubis for Kaiba to find, meaning this is all the result of malicious spirits handing out free trading cards. With the pyramid in play, Anubis has been siphoning Yugi and Kaiba's life energy in order to resurrect himself.
Behold the future. I will finally complete that which I started millennia ago. It is by your very hand that this devastation will occur, mortal. For when you released the Pharaoh, you released me as well.
Yugi! Taya!
What are you doing?
Giving the pyramid a show! What does it look like I'm doing? So Taya senses that her friends need her and... You know what? I'm just gonna let this next part speak for itself.
Taya! How'd you find us?
Are you kidding me? Remember the friendship symbol we drew?
Of course we do.
The ink may have faded, but our bond never will.
Right,
right.
We're all with you. And we'll always be with you. We'll never leave your side.
Taya!
Your pathetic little bond is nothing against my power.
No, 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 please, please, let him keep talking about friendship a little while longer, please. I haven't laughed like this in so long.
Taya! Watch out!
Kick ass!
How the mighty have fallen.
No, please, go back to the zombies. I don't need to see any more of this effing card game, okay? I already know what they're going to say.
Kaiba, we need to stop this duel.
No.
Okay.
You may have beaten me in the past, but now there's nothing you can do to stop me from having my revenge.
You're finished.
What's this? Kaiba saying the exact same words as Anubis, daring to risk the world's destruction for his own goals? I think Kaiba's experiencing hubris, a character flaw often attributed to Greek heroes. It's official, ladies and gentlemen, Kaiba is the main character of this movie. Congratulations, you rich prick. Spread your wax wings and fly.
Finish him. Finish him now. No, I wanted a perfect victory. And with this card, I can use Yugi's own most powerful monsters against him.
So in spite of the voices in his head, Kaiba uses his dragon's final special ability to destroy the Pyramid of Light so he can gain control of Yugi's god cards.
This I cannot allow.
Oh my god, it's the one thing worse than a big hairy naked guy. A big hairless naked guy.
So it's been you behind this whole duel, manipulating Kaiba all along, the Egyptian Lord of the Dead. Anubis.
I am pleased that you remember me after all these years, my pharaoh. The ultimate shadow game is just beginning.
Yeah, we're 70 minutes into this movie, pal. I think you're a little late to the game. No pun intended. So Anubis begins the next stage of his plan by, oddly enough, sticking to the card game format and summoning his own monsters.
Soon worms will feast on your flesh, just as they did on mine.
Your worms will have to wait, Anubis.
He did not just say that.
Your worms will have to wait, Anubis.
He totally just said that. Go back to the zombies!
So smaller Yugi realizes that the prophecy says that the only way to stop Anubis is with the Dagger of Fate.
Here it is. Let's just hope that fate is on our side!
Remember, kids, sharp objects succeed where trading cards fail. But in spite of his terrible aim, Yugi manages to weaken the Pyramid of Light, so the Pharaoh plays a card to resurrect the Blue-Eyes Shining Dragon and destroy it once and for all.
Now then, Anubis, this is still a duel, and I still have one face-down card to play! Reverse of Reverse, which allows me to use the last card played by Kaiba! Return from the different dimension!
No way. That was a well-executed planned payoff! This movie did something right?
So Yugi summons the Egyptian god cards and claims his victory. Wow, that was a rewarding duel. I feel so satisfied seeing the plans of this dastardly villain foiled after knowing him for the whole of 5 minutes. Oh wait, my mistake, he's back. So Anubis launches one last anticlimactic attack. Only this time, the monsters are real.
Wait, what?
If the monsters are real, so are all their powers, including this dragon's ability to destroy any monster!
How does that work? And if the monsters are real, shouldn't there be some moral implications to forcing them to fight each other? It's Pokemon all over again!
He's not coming back again, right?
No one could return after suffering a defeat so thoroughly devastating as that. Well, no one but Kaiba, that is.
If it wasn't for that freak crashing the party, we both know that the winner of today's duel would have been me.
So Kaiba leaves with the promise that he and Yugi will duel again. I imagine someone then mugs him off screen and steals the Blue-Eyes Shining Dragon, as we'll never see it again, nor will the events of this movie have any impact on the continuing storyline.
What Kaiba doesn't get is that victory means nothing, unless you can share it with the people you love. Cause then, you're really a winner.
You can say that again.
Oh, so that's the moral of this story. Do I even need to say anything at this point?
This movie is stupid. Even for a show about trading cards, it's stupid. It's a half-assed story with a bogus villain, no character growth, and no impact on the continuing storyline. Add the dubbing prowess of 4Kids, and you get a 90-minute commercial for a card game that makes no sense. But even before the bad dialogue and the crappy editing, there's a serious lack of logic to this movie. For example, if Pegasus only made one card that could stop the gods, why would it be a card that only Kaiba could play? And if Yugi has such reservations about facing Kaiba in a duel, why does he agree to face Kaiba in a duel? And sure, the show's no prize winner either, but for all its goofiness, you at least get the impression that some effort was put into it. That's what makes the Abridged series so much fun to watch. This movie, on the other hand, just comes across as lazy, thrown together at the last second for the sole sake of selling trading cards.
And damn it! It worked. I'm Neil Nash, and this is what we had to watch.
I'm by winning. I win here and I win there. Now what?